We have with us the world-renowned Kathak player, Kathak dancer, Aditi Bhagwat, who is not only a Kathak dancer but also a very improvisational dancer who fuses various types of art forms into her dance. It is very fortunate that we have her with us today performing for Ekal Vidyalaya along with her group. Aditi ji, thank you very much. And then can you please tell us your experience about today's program and then your inspiration to work with Ekal Vidyalaya?
Sure. First off, I would like to give a warm welcome to all the viewers of Desi Plaza. Well, it has been a wonderful experience being associated with Ekal Vidyalaya since the last 2 years, actually. Because when we conceived this show was in 2012, when I met a few committee members and they spoke to me about the work of Ekal Vidyalaya. And it's not that I wasn't aware of what Ekal Vidyalaya does. I have been aware of Ekal Vidyalaya and its activities since the time I've been visiting America. And I'm very fortunate to know that eventually in the year 2014 they chose me as the cultural ambassador for Ekal Vidyalaya. Our initial talks began way back in 2012 when we were planning to put forth a unique concept for the viewers of Ekal Vidyalaya fundraising concerts, because as far as I know, Ekal Vidyalaya has always hosted mostly musical shows, Bollywood based musical shows, and which is when I put forth an idea. I said, you have lovely audience, you have this lovely setup, and Ekal Vidyalaya is directed towards literacy education, and I said, why cannot we present something which is more cultural, from the roots of India, and let's highlight the classical culture that our country is blessed with, of course the golden era of Bollywood, and then moving on to the current waves of globalization, to many different kind of themes all put under one roof in one show. And that's where Avartan was born, this show that I performed today here in Dallas. And it was a splendid experience. Every Ekal chapter has been very, very supportive. The audience has been amazing, and all of us, all the five artists, the other five artists with me are Pandit Kalinath Mishra on tabla, we have Sangeet Mishra on the sarangi, Gautam Sharma on the drums and djembe, and our singer and harmonium keyboard player Vaibhav Mankad. So these five elements, and of course myself, and I often present Bollywood dances, I present Kathak, I present Lavani, and I present fusion collaborative dancing. So when these five elements have come together, we are hoping that the audience will accept us and that we will have more and more people enrolling into this huge mission that Ekal Vidyalaya has undertaken. And I feel deeply for this foundation. I happened to visit one of the schools of Ekal Vidyalaya and one of the villages that Ekal Vidyalaya has undertaken for rural development, and it was really amazing to see how Ekal Vidyalaya has changed the lives of these people there, who do not even know what a book looks like or how you speak good language. And these are the backward classes, these are the tribals that need to come forth and get educated, because our country is, well, an agricultural country. A large part of our country resides in these villages. Until and unless they come forward and they are educated and taken to a better future, I don't see where India is going. So I think Ekal Vidyalaya is playing a very, very vital role in bringing about that change that India is waiting for.
I really appreciate you absorbing what Ekal actually is doing, because we've seen several artists come and perform for Ekal, but you are the person who have really absorbed the essence of Ekal, and then you have put together a message that each and every person can understand and then relate to. Especially the performance today, your performance was superb, and then similarly Kalinath Mishra ji or Vaibhav ji or Gautam ji, and also Sangeet, you've done an awesome job in putting together a great team. Now, asking you specifically about your Kathak dance, right? Typically, I mean, the way I understand is people get into one particular dance form and then go very deep into it. But now what you have done is you have made it in a such a way that everyone can relate to it.
Yes.
So what is that inspired you to break the tradition, but at the same time hold on to it, and at the same time give it to the people where they can absorb and enjoy?
Like, there's this classic saying that in order to break the rules, you need to know the rules first. So after obviously 28 years of formal Kathak training, I have seen the world changing, and I can see that sometimes when people become non-absorbing of classical culture, if they are somehow presented the same in a slightly different package, where you know you kind of give them themes that they can relate to, they can think of, or something that is out of their memory or imagination, I think the idea clicks. And this is one way of trying to preserve our culture, because it's very unfortunate that people from my generation and the next generation do not see classical music or understand classical music the way I have, or my contemporaries have, or my elders have, which is why it is very important to present them the same deal but in a different, more attractive package. And well, my journey of classical dancing has been such that after being formally trained in Kathak and Odissi, I moved on to performing folk dances like Lavani, Rajasthani folk dances. Then I moved on to collaborating with some very, very good jazz musicians and world percussionists like Sivamani, Louis Banks back in India. And I said, why can't I handpick all these different ideas and collaborate them and put them under one show, instead of just focusing on one Kathak recital or one Lavani recital or one fusion recital? Why not give the audience what I can do best? So I handpicked all these little themes and I put them all under one roof. And I'm very fortunate that the musicians who are performing with me are of that caliber and of that level of performance, that they can entirely support my idea of performing classical, then performing film-based music, of performing fusion, then Sufi, then folk. So they are all as multi-talented as I am. So I think it has given rise to a perfect blend of ideas and a mixture of talent. And I think, which is why that inspired me. I said, why not? Why can't a layman watch Kathak? And why can't a classical-minded artist, a purist, watch a Bollywood dance? Which is why even my Bollywood dances are often based off themes from classical dancing, like the Navras or the Ashtanayika, or certain common themes like Sola Shringar or the beauty of the night. So various different compositions based off one concept of night. So I kind of try and build a concept around everything that I perform, which kind of makes it more interesting for every person to understand, whether it's a purist or a common man.
Aditi ji, one last question. There are a lot of children here, girls and some boys too, they are learning Kathak and some are learning Kuchipudi and Bharatanatyam. They are in United States, I mean, you know, and I'm sure there are a lot of people in other countries learning too. They're not exactly in India where they're absorbing everything from the cultural standpoint, but they're here. Again, they're also absorbing to an extent. The communities are bringing together various events. However, what is your message, or what are your words of encouragement for those people learning all these dance forms, and any message that you would like to give to them?
My only message is there is no two way to working hard. You have to work hard. You have to pursue an art, stay determined, give that kind of devotion that you need if you wish to achieve something. Yes, people can pursue a hobby, people can do something because they enjoy it, but if they are looking forward to being professional, being on stage, mastering an art, all you need is constant focus, constant concentration, determination and devotion, and nothing comes easy. This level of performance or expertise does not come easy. So there's a lot of hard work that goes in, and there is no other way to get it. That's my only message. If they love dance, love it such that whenever you're even performing Kuchipudi or Kathak or even a simple Bollywood dance, it should reflect on your face. That happiness should show. That's all.
Aditi ji, I really appreciate you taking time in spite of a very tiring concert. The Dallas community really enjoyed your show, and then we wish you great rest of your tour and rest of the journey in life.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Jai Ho.